Hello WordPress enthusiasts and web content creators. I was testing some Elementor Pro features for a new video and I got an idea. What if I'll show you how to create a hero section like this for any WordPress website with the free version of Elementor? Then save it as section template and reuse it anytime you want. Are you interested? Keep watching. At the end of the video, you will know how to use the subtle zooming effect for your background slider and get this immersive visual experience. Let me exit to dashboard and go to plugins to deactivate Elementor Pro so I can avoid any confusion. All these great features are available for free. Okay, let's go back to the page I built so far. As you can see, the only missing thing here is the animated headline, which is a Pro widget gone once I deactivated the plugin. I want to replace the word Pro in the big title with Free and the word Better below with Great. It's so true. You can design a great looking website with this free page builder, but you already know that. As I mentioned, I'm working on a new video. So click the subscribe button below and ring the bell to get notified when the next video will be published. Do you have something specific you want to learn about Elementor? Let's chat about that in the comments section below. If you are wondering what theme I recommend for Elementor, I could say any theme out there. It doesn't matter. There are, however, some themes that are specifically optimized for Elementor, like Hello Elementor, Astra, Ocean WP, Nivi, which is our WordPress theme, and so on. Check out the recommended video above to see some excellent WordPress themes to start a website in 2020. Now that everything is set up, let's add a new template. Name it Hero, click Publish, then push this big blue button Edit with Elementor. It doesn't matter which page layout you are using here, because you can select that later when importing the template. However, for a clean visual editing experience, I would recommend the Elementor canvas layout. Now you can go ahead and select the structure of your section, which is one column in this case. The first thing you need to do next is to set the height of the hero section as 100% minimum. To do that, open this drop-down menu and choose Min Height. Set its value to 100 and click VH above. I think you should click VH first and then adjust the value over here to see the changes. Okay. To access these settings anytime, click the six dots above the section. Now go to the Style tab, choose the background type as Slideshow, and upload the images you want to use. I've downloaded these images from pixabay.com, so you can go there and download any image you want for free. Once images are uploaded, click the Insert Gallery and move on. Feel free to play around with these settings until you get the best look on both mobile and desktop views. I think cover for the background size and center for the background position is perfect, at least in my case. Now you can go ahead and drag over the heading element, align the text to center, change its color to white, the font family if you want that, and so on. I'll choose this, but you are free to choose from hundreds of Google fonts in this drop-down. Set the text weight to 900. Type in Elementor, and that's it. I will make the text a little bit bigger. To do that, drag this cursor to the size that fits perfectly over the background in the desktop view. Duplicate the text element to work faster, change its content and some settings in the Style tab, and make some adjustments until everything looks perfect. For the last line, duplicate the text element one more time and type in WordPress website or whatever you want. Adjust the settings into the Style tab and then go to the next step, which is to add the button element. Drag it over right below the last text line. Choose Center Alignment over here. Replace the text with In 2020 and Beyond and move on. You can set the link over here. Choose the proper button size in this drop-down and add a specific icon to the left or right. I will use the video icon, but you are free to choose from hundreds of other icons in the library. Click Insert once you find the perfect match, and then go ahead to the Style tab. Change the text color, make the background transparent, and set a solid border value 1 all around. The color should be white here too, but the radius is up to you. You can make the corners as curved as you want. My favorite value here is 3. Then you can add a slight shadow to the button and change the hover settings too. As a finishing touch, add a top margin of 100 pixels to the button element, adjust the sizes of the text elements, and add some margins here too. Then you are done. That's it. If I click on Preview over here, we can notice that there is only one thing left to do. Two, actually. I need to enable the zooming effect and the text overlay. To do that, go back to the Style settings of the section and enable the Ken Burns effect over here. Now the image is zooming in slightly for each slide, as you can see in the preview, and the Elementor text will blend with the background nicely once you select the overlay option in this drop-down. Looks fabulous. Use what you've just learned for a memorable hero section on your website or for your clients. Now it's time to save it as a section template. To do that, click on the tiny arrow near the update button and choose Save as Template. This will actually save your work as a page template. To save it as a section template, right-click on the 6 dots above and choose Save as Template in the menu. You can export that template as well and use it anytime you create a new website with WordPress and Elementor. Here is how you can use it on a new page, for example. Go ahead and exit to the dashboard, then hover over the new element on your top bar and click on Page. Name it as Landing Page or Home. Click Save Draft or Publish it. Then push the big blue button Edit with Elementor. Once the editor interface is loaded, choose the page layout as Elementor Canvas or Elementor Full Width, depending on what kind of page you want to create. I use and recommend the Elementor Canvas for any landing page and the Elementor Full Width for pages where you need to display the default header and footer of WordPress. For this particular page, I'll choose Elementor Canvas and insert the saved template over here, which you can find in the My Templates tab. It will be the Hero section template, so click on Insert over here, choose Yes to import document settings as well, and wait for the results. It looks like the page template went back to default, So go ahead and select the proper layout over here, and you are done. That's it.